The other day I lost 2 hours on a seemingly simple styling issue. I was trying to use the collapse component from the AND design library, but no matter what I tried, the chevrons didn't look right when included inside my app. And the thing is, it worked everywhere I tried except my app. The most experienced of you might think about a CSS style conflict that might have caused the chevrons to look off within my app, but that didn't turn out to be the case. In fact, the answer was a lot more interesting, mysterious, and difficult to track down. Follow me into this rabbit hole, I guarantee it will be an interesting journey, and it might even save you some time in the future. Everything started with a simple task, creating an HTML report for some business metrics. Nothing fancy, just a static HTML page to display some data and values. Because it was only for limited internal use, it didn't need to be beautiful or complex, so I went with the easiest strategy, creating a template and then using handlebars to populate it with data. Basically, you simply write a template with some placeholders and handlebars injects the data, creating the final HTML. All good so far, but I wanted to use some components to better display the values. Given that we were already using the AND design library in other areas of the project, I thought to give it a go for consistency. But there was a catch. The AND library is built for React, but I needed something that could work with static HTML pages. Of course, I could have used some alternatives like Bootstrap, but instead I went with a quick hack. If you copy the CSS and the rendered HTML from the spec panel, things often work out of the box depending on the library. So I went ahead and created a basic HTML page, adding the AND CSS styles in the head tag and using the various components as discussed above, pasting the HTML directly. All the components worked perfectly, except the collapse, which didn't look quite right. Indeed, the chevrons looked off. At first, I thought it was caused by the hack of using the HTML directly, but that didn't turn out to be the case, because pasting the CSS and HTML directly on a brand new code pen worked perfectly. So there must have been something within my app that was causing these problems. I spent a good portion of the next hour comparing the styles between the collapse inside my app and the one on CodePen, trying to figure out if some styles was causing the conflict. But unfortunately, the styles, and most importantly the computed styles, were identical, and after a lot of time I still couldn't explain the behavior. I was stuck. And in those cases, there's one simple technique that helps a lot, usually, taking a short break. And so I did. With a fresh mind, my next idea was trying to change context a bit to see if I could gather some more information and get unstuck. I tried opening the HTML page on Firefox, hoping that different development tools might provide some useful information. And I was lucky, because while the CSS styles looked the same, a console warning got my attention. Page layout may be unexpected due to Quirks mode. Wait, what exactly is Quirks mode? I had never heard of that before. Fast forward a few seconds and a quick Google search brought me the answer. Turns out modern browsers have a compatibility mode used to display legacy websites called Quirks mode. When such mode is enabled, the rendering engine works in a slightly different way to better support those old websites. In other words, it has queries. But how does the web browser know when to run on queries mode? Well, it checks if the HTML page starts with a doctype HTML. If it doesn't, then it renders it through queries mode. So I rushed to the HTML page and added the doctype declaration on top, refreshed it, and bam, the collapse was now looking perfect. That was it. The missing doctype declaration was telling the browser to render the page in Quirks mode, thus causing the layout to be different. Now, if you're into front-end development, you might have heard that you should always start your HTML pages with the doctype declaration. And to be honest, I did as well. But I never knew what consequences the lack of such statement would bring. Well, now I know. And so do you. Alright, hopefully that was helpful and interesting. If you liked it, please consider subscribing to the channel and liking the video because it helps tremendously, and I hope to see you in the next one.